Hello, everybody. Welcome to another Feed the Beast Light episode. This is episode 6, and it's been a while since my last episode, and I have made quite a lot of changes, at least to my tools and my arrangements of items and so on. I improved part of the mine shafts, and yeah. Also, I did make, not this, I made a stone excavator, a stone shovel, and a stone pickaxe. The reason I did this is for just ease of use when mining, and yeah, it just makes mining much easier. So I put some random stuff in here, of course. All the cobblestone I collected. As you can see, I compressed some of the cobblestone that I had into singular compressed cobblestone pieces. Once I have enough cobblestone, I will compress that even further into double compressed cobblestone pieces. I think the maximum compression is 8 times or octuple compressed cobblestone. So yeah, here is my ores chest. Or keep everything mostly valuable, and yeah, all the ores that I have. So yeah, it's been a while. I've been doing a bunch of things, mined out a lot of stuff, and what was it? Oh, whoops. And I broke some tools, had to make new ones, and so on. Let's try and repair that if we can. There you go. No, just two. Today I think I'm gonna go mining once more. I still need more resources. So that I can start building other things, start building more technology. It's important because, as I said in the previous parts of my series, I wanted to automate pretty much everything or as much as I could because I just want to, it's like a goal. But yeah. So in order to do that, we need lots of resources and we need machines. Right, let's collect some of this wheat. There you go. Three more bread. I need to make a new lumber axe to chop down these trees that I have in the front. So yeah, let's get rid of this. Put my watering can, even though I do not need it. Actually, I'll just throw it out. And I will show you guys how I actually mine effectively in my mine shaft. I'm gonna take care of the zombie here. All right. So yeah, I'm gonna show you guys what I personally do to mine effectively and as well as it to be pleasing or like having some type of aesthetic to it. There you go. Get rid of this. I have an excavator now, so I can mine out. I mean, I can dig large swaths of dirt, gravel, sand, etc. With ease. All right. So for something like this, I just take it out. There you go. Coal. More coal. coal, even more coal. Lapis. That's unexpected. There you go. Alright, so I have to cover this up somehow. So I just use cobblestone blocks to cover this up. Like this. There you go. I think I'll mine out this tin. Ferrous as well. Alright, and I just put the cobblestone back in its place, or to cover up these holes that I made. There you go. We encountered a water pit, which isn't very good because I might have to mine through this. But hey, look at that, there's diamonds. Let's see. It's one, two. How am I gonna do this? There you go. Oh, my hammer ran out of durability. Unfortunate, but I can fix this very easily since I made a tool station. I can plop this right down, take my hammer, and fix it very easily. There you go. Easy repairs, and I have it as a mobile thing, so I can just carry it with me on my mining trips. Very effective. Oh, a note about, during the time that I wasn't recording and playing, I have died a couple times, but fortunately, I'm not sure which mod does this, but, instead of losing all my items and having them disappear, there's a mod that puts a grave where you died and stores all the items into the grave. Now, I've read that this grave works anywhere. It doesn't matter where. Like, it can work in, I think, the air. It can work in lava. It can work pretty much anywhere. So it'll store your items safely even when you die, and it'll store it at the place of your death, even in lava. So that is very helpful for me because I'm going to be mining a lot, and maybe something goes wrong, and I, let's say, fall into a pit of lava, and it means that I just won't lose my items, which is great because at this early point, at this early stage into the game, having losing all your items can be a severe disadvantage for the future. So yeah, that's my thoughts on it. Really helpful modification to the game. At least this mod pack. Yeah, since that's kind of my reasoning. You start off with nothing, or like, yeah, nothing, and then you slowly build your way up, and you're just starting to progress, and then all of a sudden, you lose all your progress, basically, if you have your entire inventory into a and I mean, if you have all your items into your inventory and then all of a sudden you die in a pit of lava or you die very far away and you don't know where you died. So, having those items always accessible by grave use is very, very helpful. You go. We mine pretty quickly for a stone hammer. I think we're at the point where I don't need to worry about holes anymore. Looks like we ran out of space. Again, man, we fill up so quickly. That's unfortunate. Well, I guess I'll just go all the way back. You go. Need to add more stone stairs to get down here. But yeah, let's smelt some of our ores, and then we can start talking about what we're gonna build and how and what we're eventually gonna do maybe with the items we build. So yeah. There you go. Tons of ores. And I can easily sort it like that. 22 diamonds. Lots of gold, 68 gold. Two stacks of iron. Two, almost a half stacks of lapis. Almost five stacks of redstone. We have plenty of materials that we can use. Alright. Oh, I think I also will repair my hammer and compress some of this cobblestone. Actually, I think I'll repair all my tools. Whoops. I think this also works here. Oh, that's very good. Look at that. That works well, so I also have the option of making a tinker table to fix my tools. There you go. Now, time to make some compressed cobblestone. That's one stack. That's the second stack. Alright, that's good enough. I do believe we can make exactly one stack of double compressed cobblestone. One stack of double compressed? Yep, there you go. That's a lot of cobblestone. So yeah, let's check on our ores. Some of them already smelted up. There you go, tons of ores. Is it turning daylight? Turning day? Yes, it is. That's good. I'm not sure what I want to do about the entrance. I think I'm just going to use more stone slabs. But I am unsure, so I guess it's just up to how I feel or what I think looks best in the end. But yeah. That should be everything, yep. Let's put all of our ores away. So now we have even more materials. 2.5 stacks of iron, that's pretty good. I think I need more obsidian to build a nether portal. I might focus on that. Kinda low on copper, because copper, I think, doesn't spawn that frequently at the lower levels. So yeah. Let us see. I think I'll work on. Oh, I can take this out of here. Put it into here. Take a lot of coal. There you go. Let's make some smooth cobblestone. Or it's just stone. Put 8 into each of these. Another thought I had was I was thinking of expanding the base to the left here, although I'm not sure how large this mountain is. I think I'll give it a try anyways. So I can I need to follow my 5-block kind of thing that I take notice of. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. There you go. So yes, we do have enough space indeed. That is very good. And I'll start taking out some of this dirt. There you go. I'm gonna take out also some of this stone. Easy enough. You can take these stone slabs and make them into these types of blocks and put them down. So there you go. Let's see how these are working fairly well. Maybe two more. Nice. We need lots of stone slabs for this room. Although I think I have some extras in my chest. I'm just gonna make sure. Yep, we might have enough already. So let's quickly set down the flooring, and then the ceiling, and the walls. There you go. Should also start removing the ceiling here. More stone. Let's turn all this into stone slabs. I think the reason why I like stone slabs is because it kind of gives it this scientific or laboratory feel to the bases that I build, and it just looks nice. So yeah, it just, I don't know, that's kind of why I like to use them so much. Throw this stuff in there. Let's take a look there. That probably should be enough stone. Just to make sure. Nope, not even close. You need just a few more. I can also make some torches. There you go. That should be enough stone slabs. With the excess, I think I'll start doing the mining portion. Fixing up this area, but yeah. So let's see what we can do. Well, we can start by taking apart this right here, kind of as a design thing. I'm actually not too worried about the stone stairs right now. I'm more worried about the look of this mine shaft all the way down. I want it to look fairly nice. So these will be spread out across. You won't be able to see the stone underlying it, except for here, which actually, yeah, I need to add some more there, just on the bottom. So doing that for every layer down and on two sides is going to be quite a challenge, but it is possible, and yeah, it'll just take quite a while. There you go. I'm gonna try adding some stone stairs and such. Stone brick stairs. It's not that side, I don't think. It's this side that is lacking the stairs. There you go. Probably still won't be able to reach the bottom, but we're getting closer. We're fairly close now. I don't know what I'm gonna put into this room. I think I'm just gonna make it a smeltery room or something. Or I could have it be a power room where I attach solar panels above this area and just put it into a capacitor or energy cell in the middle of the room and have all the energy be directed outwards into here or the bottom floors and such. So, not really sure what I'm gonna do, but just a lot of possibilities. Should be enough stone brick stairs. Whoops. Let's take this out. That's weird. Why did it end up there? Jeez, alright. No monsters nearby. No enemies, there you go. So yeah, that's basically the design I have in mind. Actually, I think I'm gonna take these out. And since I'm gonna have to put stone slabs on the sides here. There you go. Extra stone we have. Just a bit. Nothing else. All right. Let's see. We have stone slabs, we have some stone, we have some stone bricks left over. We have wood. We have plenty of building materials by now. Still, we need the stone. That's the most important part. But yeah. Let's make some more stone slabs. Let's put it right here. My pickaxe actually is about to break, so I think we should focus on repairing it right now. My red thing works. There you go. Oh, wow, that is so cheap. Wow. Only takes one cobblestone to repair it fully. Huh. Alright. Well, let's mine this out. We need two more stone slabs. Let's see, we can probably smelt some more cobblestone, I don't really mind. Repair actually all my tools. Let's use this. Actually, I'm gonna just repair my hammer. Already, we've got plenty of stone. Lots of stone slabs. Start putting them in. Over here. It seems to be looking fairly well already. But we just need to input more stone brick stairs. Let's try it out on the first levels already and see how it looks. On this side. Looks fairly good. I enjoy that. An idea I had was to add lava flowing down on both sides, all the way down to the layer 11, to the bottom of my mineshaft. But, I think that would look cool or pleasing. Not really sure. Although I'm just gonna have to work on it in future videos and such. Just like an idea I'm throwing out there. But yeah, I think that's all that I'm gonna do for this episode today. I'm probably gonna work on, yeah, just doing this all the way down, which is gonna take a very, very long time, but I don't really mind. I want to get started with some technology soon, or like more advanced technology, maybe solar flux and energy cells and whatnot, or just tinker smeltery, smelteries and stuff. But yeah. Just gonna wait for this stone to smelt up, and I'm probably gonna add it to here if I have the time. So that's it, and see you guys.